The SDK utility includes a plugin that makes it very easy to do SDK tracing. So what this is it traces all the SDK calls that are going on this machine. So whenever you start up an SDK program, it's making calls to the PI server and internally, and we can trace that with the SDK tracer. So what I have set up here is you'll need to trace until some time. So it starts now, and it goes until sometime in the future. I'm going to set it up to be 5 minutes from now, so star plus 5 minutes. I'll just let the trace level stay that way, and I'm outputting it to a debug window. So if you want to view it in a debug window live, you'll just need to download from Microsoft something called a debug viewer. And we'll save it. And now tracing has begun. Whenever I open up an SDK application like system management tools, I'll start seeing SDK calls appear in the debug viewer. And whenever I do anything with system management tools, like bring up current values or load security points, I'll see even more log messages appear here in the debug viewer. See? Okay. If you'd like to output it to a file, you have that option. So you'll just select File, and you'll select a folder. So I've pointed it towards this folder right here on my desktop. Again, you'll have some end time in the future, and you can set the trace level and trace depth. If you want it to be the maximum to include everything that's going on, you can set the trace level to 200 and the depth to verbose. If you want to know more about what these mean, you should go to Help, PI SDK Utility Help, and there's a good explanation of what the different levels do. Now, when we start up an SDK application, like another About PI SDK file, we'll see a log file come in. And as we refresh it, it'll grow. If with this tool we go and we do something like pull up snapshot values, we'll see that log grow even more. Now, once this time expires, tracing will stop. So just think out how long your operation is going to be and set it to capture the whole time.